Hello and welcome. First connection to Stormshield network security firewall. Default settings that you need to know for the first time you connect to the firewall is that port number one is considered as an external interface. It's called by default an out interface. Of course, all these settings can be modified later. Port number two, three, and so forth, all the remaining ports are actually considered as internal interfaces. All interfaces by default belong to one bridge. And the first connection should be to internal interfaces only, which means port number 2, 3, and so forth. Don't change interfaces while connected. So if you connect to the firewall, for example, on port number 2, and after some time, a few minutes later, you just unplug the cable and plug it in port number 3. So the firewall will see your IP coming from two different interfaces, and it will block the connection because this is an IP address spoofing alarm. So the default IP address of the bridge by is 10.0.0.254/8. Which is in all of the interfaces because all the interfaces are part of the bridge. By default, there is a DHCP server enabled on all of the interfaces of the bridge. Distributes an IP range between 10.0.0.10 up to 10.0.0.100. Default username and password is admin, and the URL you need to connect to the web administration page is https://10.0.0.254/admin. And of course, if it's your first time you connect to the firewall, it will redirect you to a page for the installation wizard. Now, this is a simple example of one of the Stormshield firewall models. You can see that port number one, it's named out by default. Of course, everything can be modified later. So port number two, three, four are all internal interfaces, has different names, and these names can be also modified later. All the interfaces by default belong to one bridge with an IP 10.0.0.254/8. DHCP server is also enabled on all of the interfaces, distributes an IP 10.0.0.10 up to 10.0.0.100/8, and the internal interfaces, which are the interface number 2, 3, and all the remaining interfaces, are actually considered as internal by default. So you, when you want to connect to the firewall for the first time, you have to choose any of these interfaces, and only by default port number 1 is considered as external, so don't try to connect to the firewall for the first time from port number 1. This is an example I want to show you. So I have my laptop connected to port number 3 of the firewall, internal interface, and I put an IP 10.0.11/8 from the same subnet, or maybe I can just simply use the DHCP, it will be the same. When the first time I connect to the firewall, I will need to enter the IP address and /admin. So you are going to the authentication page of the firewall. Of course, since the firewall is using HTTPS, so the certificate of the firewall is not trusted by default on your browser, so you just need to add the exception. It depends on the browser, actually. You have different ways of adding the exception. So I would just say, permanently store this exception, so every time I connect to the firewall, I don't see this warning. So, as you can see, I will be immediately redirected to the administration page where I can log in using my username and password. Now, if it's your first time, of course, to the firewall, which is not the case, you will be redirected to this URL, actually, which is 10.0.0.254/install. This can be called also anytime. And this URL will redirect you to the quick installation wizard. It will ask you, for example, for the default password. And then it will launch a wizard where you can configure the firewall step by step. And that's all. So, thank you. If you need more information, you can find them in our Stormshield portal, mystormshield.eu, and you can find a lot of knowledge base articles and also a lot of documentations that help you. Thank you for watching.